Describe Camphill. It's great. That's a really interesting.
Question.
Yeah, it's a broad question. It is.
Camphill is a nice place for residents. In my opinion, is for them is paradise.
For me, it's like a comfort place for the residents, really. It's a home, basically.
Yeah.
And for me, it became a home as well. You feel confident, you feel comfortable, and that's what it's like. Yeah.
It's a community. It's a community where people live together, work together, share highs and lows together. We have volunteers from all over the world who come to live here.
Here, they are free. They have many different activities like swimming, dance, art, craft, and workshops, farm, garden, and pottery, weavery. So they feel very well. It's a really paradise for them. And for me, it's a good experience because I think that like people, I'm growing. I'm better like a man, you know, because I know how the residents feel and know more about the world, my vision. Open.
I know it was set up because at the time of the war, they were trying to move a lot of refugees, which were included children with intellectual disability, to safety. And a very pioneering young man, Rudolf Steiner, set up a community initially in Scotland, was the first one. And that community became like a safe haven for everybody there. But he also developed a community. He wanted it to be a community where everyone was valued and treated equally and could grow up not being seen as being different to anyone else.
You see people who come from different countries with different values, different cultures, and we all share that together. And everyone gets to taste Philippine food, Brazilian food, and we all just share what we experience in different countries, like, and bring it all together here. And we find out that we all have so many things in common, even if we are all from different parts of the world. Like.
It's amazing because we have opportunity to learn about different cultures, about different nations, languages, foods. And I'm Brazilian, but my idea about something, my opinion is different because we are the different place, you know. Yeah.
Thank you.
I was renting a house with my two children in Ballymoney, and in the back garden there were lots of cows, and people used to walk past the door every evening up and down. I wonder, where do these people come from? Because most of them are foreign. And in a small community where you don't see many people, I was curious. So I went for a walk with my twins, and there was a big wooden sign propped up against a bush, and it said Camphill open day. And we came in, and there was this hive of activity. There were people from various parts of the world, lots of people with intellectual disabilities, and everything possibly you can hand make was there available for people to buy. I was blown away by the whole community. Never knew it was here until that day. And then I thought, yeah, I'd like to work there.
I was born in Gorey and I grew up, I spent the first 10 years of my life here in Dovcarrig, and I'm back now for the past 3 years doing the estate maintenance. Like, I remember when I was like really, really young, there wasn't a difference between residents and co-workers, you know, it was just people that we all lived together with, you know. And I think growing up in that situation will help you sort of, you know, be a bit more tolerant of people that are different, or be a bit more patient and stuff with people as well. I think it's a good way to grow up, yeah, absolutely.
My relationship with the residents is because I lived in Cluna House, I had a good connection with them. I know, I understand when they feel pain, when they need something. I just look. Yeah, I know.
I started in November. I'm actually on a two scheme, so I'm going to be here for a year. Starting in the farmyard, cleaning out the cows, feeding them, the pigs and the chickens, and getting involved with the milking as well. Yeah, I'm just really enjoying it. You know, never thought I would. I'm a carpenter by trade, and this is just totally different to me. But it's fantastic. You're out in the open. Especially what's nice is the people. The people are just fantastic, like, you know, and they're so dedicated in what they're doing. And it's really worthwhile, you know, working with people that are disabled and, you know, and trying to get through to them and involving them in the farmyard as well and other activities.
This is one of the looms where one of the residents works. He needs support when he's using it, but if you give him just a little bit of support, he'll just keep going, and he sit here smiling all the time because he loves weaving. Some of the residents are actual weavers. They've been coming here for over 30 years, so they know exactly what to do. So it's a case of everybody just helps each other. We produce a lot of things that will be sold then at various times throughout the year.
I think that sort of difference between here and sort of other care homes are that the residents are able to contribute to the community and sort of have that sort of satisfaction of, yeah, being able to sort of bring something to where they live and make the place better for themselves.
In the garden, I'm a gardener. Of course, plant vegetables, flowers, weeding, but my favorite plant is strawberry.
The farm is just great. Getting used to it, it took me a while to get used to it, obviously, and being quite scary of the cows to start off with. But your confidence grows, and it's another skill. But I always wanted to get into, you know, get a bit of land and get maybe a few sheep and that and start, because I think it's in my blood, you know, and it's something that I would really like to do. I really like the chickens because they never complain. Don't need to do much work with those either, like, you know.
There has been a lot of changes, yeah. When I was very little, there was only two employees here. There was the maintenance man and someone in the office. The rest would have been volunteers. Back then, there would have been house parents instead of house coordinators. So now the people that run the houses are employed. But back then, it would have been families, essentially, that would have run the houses. Like, my parents met here, actually, as young co-workers and then became house parents. So they would have sort of run the house with their families. We would have lived in the houses with the residents. My two sisters actually were born in Bridget House and one of the houses here in the community.
I think it's important that you're working together with people on an equal level and seeing them develop and, you know, learn new skills or be open to trying different things, and we're there to support that and just seeing the residents happy, you know, seeing they have a good day. You know, they go to bed tired because they've been active and
they feel confident about themselves when they know that you're there for them and they can do these things by themselves with your support. Being a volunteer means that you're doing this wholeheartedly, like you're doing this because you want to do it. So, but also you get tired too. Yeah, I think that's the part that I don't like.
Yeah, the hours are long, the work is difficult. It's a very busy day. Most days it's 12-hour shifts. Camphill isn't without its problems. There are a lot of problems here too, but we're all working together to try and resolve those problems now. I think somebody said that one of the greatest challenges in Camphill community is trying to maintain harmony. And I have to agree with that, yeah.
It's been an eye-opener for me. It's hard work, but it's just so rewarding. It seems to me, no matter what anyone's doing, when they're needed, they're there. So there's got to be something about this place in particular. Like, people are just, as I say, are so dedicated in what they're doing. And you know, you can walk away from it, and as long as the animals are happy, I'm happy. You know.
Everybody works together. It's because the residents work and we all work to feel valued. You know, we all have a sense of purpose. And that's what the residents get in Camphill, where they don't get another residential care. It is a community where people work and they feel valued because of the work. And at the end of the day, they've contributed as much as everybody else to the community. And yeah, that makes Camphill special.
I know that the work is really, really tiring sometimes and it just drains you, but you have to enjoy the little things. Like, I've seen residents who who are so down, but then you give them a can of Coke and they are very happy. They just, it turns things around, and it's just, you see that and you just, it's totally a different experience, and you just learn so much from them and learn both ways, from the residents, learn from staff, from other co-workers, and eventually everything will go smoothly.
People don't know what means Camphill community, you know? And if they come, I think that their mind changes about the community, about the special needs, you know? Yeah, come on.